So when you are like, I use artists for an example because it's so common, right? I use artists a lot and I use business owners a lot, but more artists. Because artists come and say, I got the best music. I'm like, so what? Who's heard it? You can be the most talented guy in the basement and no one gives a shit because you're not putting it out.
Yeah.
If you show the process and then you put it out, they're gonna be like, man, this guy worked hard and his shit is good. His product is amazing.
Right.
Like, man, I love that man's work ethic. This is why people fall in love with characters, because of the work ethic. They're visualizing the things that they can't do.
Right.
See what I'm saying? Like, I said, if you want to be successful, what are you willing to do that the next man is not willing to do? See, when you're putting content out, people think that it's supposed to pop, pop, pop. And I'm like, what do you have that's supposed to pop? You have to have a body of work.
Yeah.
And that's the problem. It's the body of work. No one wants to put a body of work together.
I think a lot of that has to do with where we're at stage-wise.
Right.
It's glorification of everything, and people are missing the process at which it took to get there.
Right, but here's the thing about it, right? Like the writing process. I'm always interested in how a person writes. Like for me, if you know me, I have a note 9, okay? I'm a little outdated. See, they have this little magical pen. So when I get ideas about new businesses, I write them down. If you've seen what this looks like, it would really baffle your mind, okay? On my notes section. See, and then when you take that from notes, it's just from notes, then you put it into an executive summary, a business plan, okay? And then you start putting a structure behind it and fund it, and it becomes something, you're gonna be like, holy shit, that works. See, now you've intrigued the mind to show the process, which you lit a spark that created a flame,
right?
And that's what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to take this, show the growth of it, show the whole process, take that, and then now when it starts becoming, or if it becomes large scale, then people are gonna be like, well, how did you get it there? But if you show the process, it's gonna circumvent that where they're gonna know how to get there.
Right, you can't now just pull up a sign
and
expect it to come.
Right, but now you're creating a good following, but you're creating bosses.
Yeah.
See, because you show the process. And this right here, the process, is more informative than that bullshit academic that's in school.
I'd agree.
Like, school don't teach you how to market. That's the problem with these people. You want to make more jobs, you want to employ more bosses, the school should be showing this. But this generation should be showing what it's lacking in the schools.
Yeah.
See, that's what I'm more intrigued with. That's why I'm giving this. See, but with this generation, because they're materialistic, I have to show the exotic cars.
Right.
Just to captivate their mind. Just to get your attention.
Yeah.
And then it's up to me to give you the content to show you how to get from this point to this point. See, I don't want to fool anybody. I'm not doing this for cool points. I'm doing this to implore people to use things and go through the process and understand that the process is more important than the money. Because if you perfect the process, the money is what you get at the end. See what I'm saying? But I'm also trying to show people that you can't do everything on your own. It takes a whole team. And it takes a whole team to create and brainstorm to create a plan.
Yeah.
You can be the visionaire, but you can't do everything. And that's what I'm trying to show people through social media. It takes a whole team. If you look at anybody, I use this guy, we have not a lot in common, but Gary Vee, right? Like, he has a guy that films for him. He has a whole team that runs the business, but you didn't get to see that whole process. See, that's what I wish they filmed. That's what I wish that they would film is how we got to that point, and that's why I'm doing it now. Mm-hmm. Because if you are an upcoming artist, or if you are an upcoming entrepreneur, or if you have ideas, or if you just want to be a social personality, it takes consistency, but it also, that people want to see the growth. They're going to be like, man, that was shit back in the day. And then when it gets better production, they're going to be like, well, this is pretty cool, because I remember when he was a scrub.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Like, people look at it. That's like, when I look at, like, interviews, like, with Dame Dash, he's like, I founded Kevin Hart. He was a scrub. Look at where he's at now. Like, You saw his process.
Yeah.
He took the shitty roads to get to the top. See what I'm saying? Like, I want to show that.
Yep.
I want to show that, but also I want to show that it's for free. Like, how could you not take time to market yourself? And then the crazy part is you could be in the toilet taking a shit and you're watching Facebook instead of posting a video of what you did yesterday, showing the grind, or going on YouTube, posting that while you're in the toilet. This is how crazy it is. This is how mobile it is.
Yeah.
While you're in the toilet, gaining followers while you're in the toilet. This is how easy it is. And I'm saying toilet because that's lost time, right? You shouldn't lose time. So while you're in the toilet, you're like, follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me, follow me.
It sounds funny, but every single person watching right now can absolutely relate to holding that while
right.
on the toilet.
That's what you said. So that's lost time.
Yep.
If you're not doing that, you're watching other people's videos. That's what trips me out.
Right.
I don't, like, I support other people, but I'm trying to put my shit out.
I think that's where more of an open mind can come into play, as well as the fact that, just like you were saying, most of the time when I'm watching a video, wherever I'm at, and I'm watching a video, like, it doesn't click at the time that, like, there's somebody taking that video. You know, there's somebody, they have a team of people that's dedicated to making sure that their story and their success and their glorification or whatever it is put out there. And I really think that is a means of correctly using social media.
Yeah.
Is to get your story out there. But to also be open-minded enough to know that there's a lot more sometimes to the story than meets the eye.
Yeah.
If the person's not showing it. If you're seeing car after car after boat after car after boat after money stack after, you know, all of it, the only thing that you see is just a ton of professional photos and lavish lifestyles. There's so much more to the story than that. And obviously it happened somewhere. It wasn't a get-rich-quick scheme. There's no such thing.
You know what I hear all the time? Here's what trips me out. Me and James go everywhere because, you know, James is a big guy and he's my security when we're gone, yeah. like on the road. And
yeah.
So I wear a lot of jewelry. It's not about what they do. It's about having eyes behind my back, right? It's, I hear, what do you do? What do you do for them? My response to them is, I do what you're not willing to do.
Yeah, that's a perfect response.
You get what I'm saying? And then they look at it as me being arrogant. But I'm like, we make choices. The next question is, well, how can I get on? Well, how about you start your own shit and ask for mentorship?
Yeah.
See, this is what I'm getting at, is it's not about how can you show me how to go eat or how to fish, it's how can you give me fish? See what I'm saying? Like, and what we have to do from this point, like the J Majors, I haven't seen a lot of videos lately, and he's a busy guy. But his videos, and I want people to look into this on Facebook, Jay Majors, look at his production. It's nutty. But look at the beginning part of it. You can see the process of him evolving. Just like you're seeing DTI.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Lex Talks evolve. Liquid Gold, trying to build an anticipation so when I open the doors for Liquid Gold that we got orders and it's going to pop because we made a building. Because of content.
Right.
And we're using visuals and audio to play a big part of that.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Like, and then Diverse Technology Investment Group, like showing the process of investing in things. Like, and then people, new opportunities just fall in your lap because people see the process and that I want to partner with them.
Yeah.
Or how can I sign that person? Or how can I do business with them or her?
Right.
Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And if you're a comedian, you can't be shit without content. If you're an actor, you can't be shit without content. See what I'm saying? If you're a model, you should have 100,000 pictures.
Right.
Hustling three times a day, until it catches somebody's eye.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? Like, if you're a designer, same thing. Show the concept, show the process of your design, and then, you know, how it came into fruition. Like, that's what I'm getting at. It's like, no one, and because it's a visual thing now, it's easier to captivate an audience. It really is.
Right.
Display that work ethic, because people don't really want to read a fucking book anymore. Let's be real.
That's true.
That's why audiobooks took off.
Big time.
Okay?
Big time.
That's why it took off, because people's attention span has shrank.
Yep.
But they can process a lot different because it's visual and audio.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So you have to see how things have shifted. Everything they do now is digital. You send an email, what is that? Digital.
You're not writing on paper.
Right. Yeah. You send them a text, what is that?
Digital.
And visual.
Yeah.
You get what I mean? Like, and it's music now streaming everywhere.
Everywhere.
And it's audio. Yeah. With visuals on that, but it's not even great visuals like the 1990s productions.
Yeah.
It's all based off little cameras.
Yep.
But they can create a great visual. So there's nothing impairing people from growth except them and their excuses. But also, a lot of people are believing the false narratives of wealth. Listen, I'm going to end it at this. This is how we're going to end it. I guarantee you, to the person in Lex Talks, the audience, show me 10 millionaires that you know, literally. Show me 10 millionaires that you personally know that can show you bank stubs that they have 7, 8, 9 figures in. I guarantee you, most of you won't, but I'll show you their Instagram. It looks like they're freaking rich. Shouldn't you look at that, the results, and say, that guy is really not what he says he is. He's just trying to fake it till he makes it. And fake it till you make it doesn't work. Because you're spending so much to fake it that you miss the opportunity to invest in yourself.
Yeah.
But people are so caught up in the visuals, they're not really seeing what's behind it.
Right.
Show me, look.
You can't fake an entire house.
No.
You can't do that. I am a firm believer in fake it till you make it in very minor steps, because that grows people to be accustomed with what it takes.
Definitely.
But when, like you said, our generation is fixated on seeing a social media site that appeals to them and thinking that there's no process to get to it. But I promise you, if there was a picture from the very first picture that was posted to the very last picture that was posted of said person's face, it has changed a lot from first picture to last post. Meaning that it took a long time to get from here to here.
Right.
Even though you didn't see what was in between, there was time there.
Right.
What was happening in that time. So really, in a nutshell, today's message is to be true and not lead yourself down the wrong path.
Right.
Like, purposely lead yourself down the wrong path, which I do believe social media can do.
Yeah.
You can purposely take a right turn when you could have made a left.
Right.
And follow that narrative all the way to the end and never get anywhere but make it look like some big fancy thing. Or you can hang a right, be true to yourself, and show the process the whole way through,
right,
and receive that validation that you are where you should be, and
right,
that things are happening for the right reasons, and that those glorified pictures that may be scattered about and in between were the best word that I can use for it is earned.
Yeah.
They were earned.
Right. And let me tell you, when someone goes, when they see you, and they see everything that you had to endure, they're a fan for life. That's why people love Jay-Z, because he's shown you the process from Hard Knock Life to Rock Nation, being a part of NFL, owning Ace, owning Title, when he had Title and he sold it to Sprint. He was evolving.
Yeah.
See, he started here, and he shows you the whole process to get here. The end result, he dabbles with music when he wants to.
Right.
But you watch his growth and you support no matter what he's doing, because his validation is real. So when he stamps your name with something, it really means something.
He's left a legacy, bro.
Right.
That post number one, people are like, oh man, yeah, I think I heard of Jay-Z, but like, I don't think anybody has heard of Jay-Z.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
It's real.
And it is. And for me, I always say, look, tax season is coming. You're gonna see so many people false flagging. This is what I ask of you. And this is from an OG, okay? An older guy, okay? So here's what I ask you. And I really, really ask of this of you. Take that money and invest it. Put it away and invest it in something. I'm not gonna tell you stock, I'm not a big fan of it, even though I have some that's doing really well. I'm gonna tell you to invest it. And if you need ideas or whatever, hit my inbox, okay? But take that money and invest it so you can make a multiple. Stop buying things for image. Stop buying things because people, you're trying to appease people. Now, if it's to support your image, I get it. But invest it. Invest it where you can get a return on that investment.
Yeah.
Don't take this money and go stack it on the bed. Don't do none of that. Stop putting your business out there. Why don't you show that you took that tax money and you bought a little small store with it? Or you did whatever, you may have bought kicks that were underpriced and you sold it for a greater price, whatever it may be. But look at it from now a small loan that you have to pay yourself back. That Uncle Sam gave you some extra money and you're gonna take that money and invest it in something and eventually pay yourself back from the initial investment.
That's awesome.
That's what I hope you do. But, you know, unfortunately, I don't think some of you are gonna listen, but I hope, I pray and hope that you take that money and invest it in something that's gonna give you a return. This is Lex.
Sean.
And we look forward to talking to you next week. And we're gonna talk about next week, what do you see in a business before you invest in it? And I look forward to kind of giving you my perspective, and Sean's got some awesome questions.
I do.
And I'm grateful that we made this happen.
Nope.
And this is gonna be fun. So stay tuned and see you on the next Lex Talk.
Appreciate you guys.
Peace.